to suffering. But they at least are members of a highly disciplined organization, the regular army. The youngsters fighting as guerrillas do not have the same restraints, and with them the possible psychological effects are far more worrying. Used to enforcing their demands on the population through the power of a gun, sometimes witness to or participants in extreme brutality against defenseless civilians, it is doubtful if they will ever fully adjust to the routine and comparative boredom of normal life. This problem is not confined to Rhodesia. It is a depressing feature of all guerrilla wars, which by their very nature encourage lawlessness and a bandit mentality. As the men pack up their parachutes for use on another day, they can think only of the present. Tomorrow they may not number amongst the survivors. And indeed, shortly after this, the young para-officer was shot in the throat and killed. Is not the fear and violence on the battlefield. It is the anguish of those left behind and the agony of those who survive as physical or psychological cripples. It is the appalling waste of bravery and the destruction of dreams which all of us share. For Rhodesia, the future holds despair. If white morale collapses or the army is dismantled, there will be total chaos. Civil war will break out between Mr. Mugabe and Mr. Nkomo, and while the whites may escape, the African civilians will die in countless thousands. At least 13,000 Rhodesians on both sides have died so far. That figure could fade into insignificance.
Banana. Jungle.